Whether you are a new developer or an existing code veteran, we are only human and therefore are likely to make mistakes from time to time that can lead to errors or bugs in our code. These type of errors may be subtle and harder to notice, or maybe an obvious programming mistake, such as a mistyped variable or stylistic inconsistency. Linters and Formatter tools identify or flag potential programming or stylistic errors in your codebase, thus potentially improving the quality of your application, which can also lead to other benefits, which can make the development process a smoother experience. In this tutorial, we explore a set of questions to develop an initial understanding of linters and formatters. In later tutorials, we will take a look at the specifics of linters and individual formatting tools. Questions that we try to answer in this tutorial include who developed some of the first lint tools. Okay, so we don't really need a history lesson, but there is some valuable information here if you are new to linters that gives us a little bit of context. We then move into what are lint tools, and then discuss what the features that you might find on some of these lint tools, and then go ahead and ask ourselves the question, well, what tools are available to Python developers? This is a Python-specific tutorial. However, the underpinning knowledge here regarding linters and formatters do apply to other programming languages. We then finish up with the benefits of using lint tools, and we will include other aspects as we go along, but these are the main questions that we're trying to focus on throughout this tutorial. Let's get started with who. A little bit of history. Who developed some of the first lint tools, and where did the word lint come from? The point here is to establish the fact that linters and formatters are not new in the programming world. The term lint can be traced back to a tool called Lint, a C programming tool developed by Stephen Johnson back in 1978 at Bell Labs. There are other tools developed around this time. Lint, as it was called, was designed to analyze source code to identify compiler optimizations. So since then, lint tools have advanced to include more types of checks and can be used for many of the popular compiled or interpreted programming languages. So ultimately, you will find different tools available for different programming languages. So let's now talk a little bit about what is a lint tool. If we were just to break that question down, you might get to the following conclusion. Linters or lints are tools to help improve your code quality. If we also consider the fact that most linter and formatter tools are free, that seems like a good deal all round and something to seriously consider using. Now, if you have already utilized software tools such as Visual Studio Code, then you may have already experienced Linton in action. Many popular editors or IDEs, such as what you can see here in Visual Studio Code, have the ability or by default run linters in the background as you type. Other types of linter tools you might have to initiate or start on demand through the command line or through a graphical user interface. We can see in this example, Visual Studio Code, we've opened up a CSS file and I've created a mistake here, just a syntax error. And you can see that Visual Studio Code is giving us some indication by using different colored lines to try to identify where the mistake might be. So what you've seen there is just one of many types of features offered by different linter tools. In the previous example, we saw highlighting and identifying potential syntactical or stylistic problems. Having seen an example of CSS, linting tools will be specific to your programming language. Moving our focus to Python programming, thinking about some common mistakes that you might make in your code, Python linting tools can help you detect errors. As we mentioned, whether you are a beginner or an experienced programmer, we are only human and we tend to make mistakes. So having linting tools that will help us identify some more kind of basic or detect common mistakes such as uninitialized variables, calls to identified functions, and so on. This is going to be very useful in the development process. Moving away from syntactical and stylistic problems, there is a little bit more to this. Lint and Tools can offer a range of different services. Lint and Tools can be broken down into different categories based upon the purpose or the type of linting tool. So here we have two or maybe three categories: logical, analytical, and stylistic. The type of features that you might find on logical or analytical types of linters include code or syntax errors, as we've discussed, code with potentially unintended outcomes. We may be able to analyze for anti-patterns or dangerous code patterns or security issues. And also we could analyze with analytical linters over complex code. The second type or third type of linting tool is stylistic linters. So here, these type of tools will allow us to analyze our code to check for where code is not conforming to conventions. Just a little bit about code conventions if you aren't familiar with them. Coding conventions are a set of guidelines for the programming language. So if you're wondering how to style your code, whether that be the indentations that you should use, where white space should be, where it shouldn't be, how many blank lines you should include, or potentially whether you should be using capital letters for classes, functions, and so on, this is a guideline to help you answer some of those questions. So when we think about a stylistic convention, we think about a set of instructions which inform us how we should indent, how we should comment, make comments regarding how much white space we should include, name conventions, and for example, line length. This is just some of many of the different stylistic conventions that we can follow when developing Python programs. It is important to remember that PEP 8 is only a guideline. Where you work, your team or company might choose their own style convention that you would need to follow. The point here is that Lint Tools can help you follow, adhere to the chosen stylistic guideline by identifying in your code where it's not following the convention set out. Ultimately, this will lead to consistency, consistently styled code, which has a whole host of different benefits. Ultimately, if your code is easier to read, it's then probably easier for other colleagues to understand, and therefore potentially you are reducing the failure rate, and then ultimately you're producing better quality code. So that was a little bit idealistic, but hopefully you can start to sense and see the reasons potentially to utilize linters in your development life cycle. So now let's focus in on what options are available for Python. So here is a list of some of the more popular Python lint tools. So popular in my opinion, of course, you may have some different opinions, but if you were to type in Python linting or Python lints into Google, it's likely that you're going to see some of these different tools. So first up is Flake 8. So this is a very popular tool that we'll be utilizing, no doubt, in other tutorials. And like I said previously, there will be guides on how to start and utilize some of these tools in later tutorials. Other tools include, for example, PyLint, PyLlama, Black, PyFlakes, Radon, PyCode Style, and McCabe. So this is just a small list, a much larger list or set of linter tools that you will find by doing a quick search on Google. It can seem maybe a little bit overwhelming for new developers, all these specific tools that potentially you might utilize. And it doesn't have to be overwhelming. You will find linters such as Flake 8 or PyLlama, which combines lint tools all into one package. And that can make it easier for you to manage multiple lint tools initially, or at least speed up the startup time so that you can get to the code. For example here, Flake 8 will incorporate multiple lint tools, so PyFlakes, McCabe, and the PyCode style. So here what we have are three different lint tools. Going back to the categories or types of lint tools we mentioned earlier, here we have the three in place. So for example, Pi code style is going to be your stylistic lint. It's going to flag any stylistic problems. The McCabe tool is very much an analytical tool. It's going to analyze your code and look for potential overcomplexities. The last on this list here, PyFlakes, this is what we described as a logical linting tool. This is going to include a whole host of different services, including the checking the syntax of your code. So moving to the why would we use linting tools? Well, if you're not already sold on the idea of using lint tools to help improve the quality of your code, then here are some other good reasons, or idealistical good reasons, to consider lint tools. So first up, fewer errors in production. If we're using linters throughout the development process, this is going to help capture common errors, or not so common errors, throughout the development process, maybe before we start testing. Potentially the tests that we develop for our application will not capture some of the problems that we might experience further down the line, which some lint tools, for example, security-based lint tools, could potentially detect earlier for us, thus potentially creating a better application and a better secure application in production. We've already explored the idea of readability. Linters can help teams achieve a more readable and consistent style through the enforcement of its rules. Friendly, readable code is always welcomed and makes it a lot easier to review the code. I've used the word quality throughout this presentation, but the reality here is that quality can be very subjective. What I think is quality code, you may have a different opinion. If we think about how linters work in general, they are assessing your code for a particular use case. And by testing your certain code to check to see it against a known parameter or an expectation, then that expectation is potentially going to be met. So those expectations, or how linters are assessing your code, if your code were to pass all those tests that the linter performs, then that can be a mark potentially of quality, or at least it can be a measurable that we can use to assess the code quality. So if everyone is using exactly the same linter tools, then everyone's code is going to be checked the same. Thus, if all the code passes those checks that the linters are providing, then we could use that as a measurable assessment of the code quality. So as I was alluding to, there are lots of different types of linters that perform different tasks. Not all linters analyze source code regarding performance and safety, but you will find that some do. For a new developer, I would say that linter tools are really simple to set up and configure initially, and they provide information for free. So as a new developer, you can learn about code quality as you learn the language, as you start to create applications. And I think ultimately that's a nice way of slowly introducing code quality, or the idea of code quality, into your own practice. So that really leaves us with one last question. When do we start using linters? Well, hopefully the answer is right away. Linters and formatters are usually installed before we start developing and can be used throughout the development lifecycle. Hopefully you've got to that point where you want to start utilizing installing linter tools. Before we do that, let's take a look at formatters. To give you an example of a formatter, here I'm using black. So here I have some code. I've made a few changes. You can see that there are some stylistic inconsistencies here in how the code is presented. So a formatter is going to use a predefined set of stylistic conventions to format visually your code on the page. So if I go ahead and just run black, more information will be provided about this in a later tutorial. You can see that the code now is being nicely formatted. So we might generalize a formatter tool as a type of linter in that the formatter is providing stylistic services, which can help to improve the quality of our code. Let's drill down a little bit into two questions. What are formatters, and what, if any, is the difference between a formatter and a linter tool? So this type of question can go quite deep, but to give you a general overview here, linting is distinct from formatting, at least in my opinion, because of mainly how the linting tool operates. So linters, we say, analyze how the code runs and detects errors, whereas formatting tools restructure how the code appears. In addition to that, we could also differentiate here in that generally stylistic linters check for syntax errors and they let you know there is an issue, whereas a formatter generally just restructures the code or the appearance of the code on the page. So the benefit here of a formatter is that it's just automatic. It's going to literally just take your code and format it so you don't have to go through step by step and find all the issues and recorrect it yourself. So hopefully that's given you a starting point into linting and formatting tools, and we're now ready to go ahead and look at the specific tools and take a look at installing and starting to use and integrate within our workflow.